already the audience gets some idea what happened in the historical movement about this Mother Language Day.
We can test them if they really pay attention. No, I'm just kidding.
This is not a test quiz.
No, guys, I'm just kidding. Well, that really was educational. I mean, I myself didn't know a lot of the facts here, but yeah, thanks for that video. With that, ladies and gentlemen, now that we all know that today's event is actually hosted by DCI, the North Dakota chapter, we would now like to call upon the North Dakota chapter representative, Dr. Khwaja Hossain, who is a professor of biology and a researcher at the Naval State University, North Dakota. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Dr. Hossain.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure today to have you all attended this great event of International Mother Language Day. And as you know already, this is organized by Distressed Children and Infant International. And you can always look at this organization activities clicking on this URL here, okay? So we are part of DCI, but we are the chapter of DCI North Dakota. And we started this chapter in 2015 after tragic demise of our beloved Sijon Lama. Those who are living here for a long time, you know that it was a tragic event. And Sijon Lama was one of the beloved children of the community, and we lost him when he was only 17 years old. And from that time, with his memory, we started DCI North Dakota chapter. And from that time, we over $36,000 raised for various activities, like the activities you see today, selling food. And also many of our community members sponsoring children in poor countries like Bangladesh, India. And you can do it if you want for only $50 per month. And also, we are raising this fund through various fundraising activity, and also we coordinate fundraising activity in many other countries like in Bangladesh and other parts. Like one event is going on for a concert in Bangladesh on 20th March. Why this year? And if you look at here, 250 million children are child labor. 2,000 children die in work-related accident each year. 6 million children are working in Bangladesh. 70% of households surveyed in Bangladesh are children. And 500,000 children become blind each year. 30,000 children die each day to poverty. So if you think about all this happening and everything, the toll goes to the children. And with that, keep in mind, DCI was founded in 2009 at Yale University, and it has received that non-profit status in 2005. And it provides support in Bangladesh, India, Nepal, Nicaragua, and the active donor is 3,000. And we have about 800 active volunteers in 15 different states. So like we are in North Dakota, there are 15 other states in the USA also operating at this year. Okay. And most volunteers operated and only cost is 10%. All of the operating cost, the money we raise, only 10% goes towards operating cost. Like we have office in Boston, we have operated in Bangladesh, we have clinics in Bangladesh, and the operating cost only is 10% of the total funding. And what is the mission? Write and sight for children. DCI is a non-profit organization that works to protect child rights, help families out of the poverty cycle through education, healthcare, vision care, and income generating opportunities. And also, there's a program here, volunteers and children helping other children. So that means any children, they can work in DCI as volunteers and helping other children either in this country or any other developing country. So our comprehensive approach, we look at the education. We charge primary and secondary school. We have health program, need-based care awareness, mental and natal health, vision awareness, preventing speeding and surgery, family support, and so on. We have different types of approach to accomplish those missions as I stated earlier. We have programs like Sun Child Sponsorship, Orphan Support, Blindness Prevention, Health for Underprivileged, Youth Leadership, and Child Rights Awareness. All these six programs are operating under the DCI main office, and it is placed in many countries, including Bangladesh, India, Nicaragua, and other countries. Okay? If you look at here, one of the sponsorship programs operating in the village of Bangladesh, India, and Nicaragua. Anybody can sponsor a children only $15 per month or $50 per month to donate for amount to those day school program. Sponsorship provides basic life necessities, education, healthcare, tutoring, and family support. And American youth are encouraged to act as co-sponsor with their families. Like, you know, our family, we are doing it for our children, and you can do it whenever you want. And sponsored children who graduated from high school. If you look at this, all kids have graduated from high school through our sponsored program. Orphan support, operating in Dhaka, Bangladesh, provides shelter, basic necessities, as well as education, healthcare, training service to orphans. We have 50 orphan girls at the DCI Orphan Center. So we have a center in Dhaka, and 50 children are staying there full time, and we are taking care of this through this program. And if you look at, we have health clinic for underprivileged, operating in slum or Dhaka, one of the part of area in Dhaka, the slum areas. We have a clinic there, and already there's a doctor there. Also, we provide support through video conferencing from doctors from America. Okay? And 9,000 slum residents getting health care from that service. We have blindness prevention program operating in Bangladesh, India, and Nepal. We have over 36,000 covered by eye screening program. And if you look at these volunteer workers in the USA and in Bangladesh, all are working together hand to hand and giving support to each other. And this program is also sponsored by this year. Now let me show some success stories. What we achieved so far? Education, 1,500 children are under sponsorship support, 23 schools and 10 preschools under support. 1,052 children completed pre-primary school, 1,612 students completed primary school, 137 students completed high secondary school, and 50 orphan girls supported at DCI orphanage. This is our education program, and if you look at the numbers under health, vision, and others, I would say we really achieve, you know, lot more than what we are expecting before, and it is going on. And if you look at the left side, DCI, before DCI support and after support, you can see clearly the difference of the influence or effect of DCI support. And in conclusion, DCI is an organization with a noble cause. Whoever here, you can easily join here and part of the DCI. And through this DCI activity, any children can develop the leadership and perform the leadership in the future to come. And you can join us by sending text at the telephone number. This number is here. Also email DCI registered children. DistantChildren.org, and also we have Facebook page, and our URL is there. Last, you know, before last thanking God, I want to request you all, if you have any used smartphone that you don't use anymore, or any tablet, mobile, you don't want anymore, you can donate to us, because I am going to Bangladesh next month. 11th of March, I can carry them, because we need this equipment for our remote areas. If you have any used smartphone, you don't use anymore, you can donate to DCI or chapter. So, I know that you missed here. Mr. Barney Dardy, the president and mayor of West Fargo, was here in the beginning. He opened this program at 11 o'clock, and we are really grateful to him for coming here. Also, thanks to Jay Clemenhaupt, senior vice president of Gate City Bank. You know, he's the person who really arranged $500 for the rent of this place, and he really encouraged us all. And I think Nilo is going to declare today that he's going to be one of the advisors for this year. Okay. And Dr. Bruce Maylath, professor of English, he's going to be a keynote speaker today, and we are grateful to him for coming here and giving a speech for us. Lastly, DCI is our Dakota team member. I'm really grateful to them, the way they organized it, and special thanks go to Niloy Shaha. I think he was the pioneer one who started it, and he did a lot of work, made a lot of contact, and they helped, gathering money for this program. Also, Art, who is a beautiful lady who is, anchoring today with Niloy Shaha. Thank you for Ruchi. And also, a lot of work behind the scene. If you see all of the foods, somebody had to cook it. So all of the family here support for cooking of this food, bringing it here. I really personally thankful to them. Also their group, you see the structure here. They developed and did hard work, and really we are thankful to them for this. Anyway, thank you all for coming here today. I hope you enjoy this program. Thank you very much.